certificate guidance video, and here we have Shubham Saxena.
Yes, I am Shubham Saxena.
And Himanshu Pandey Bhardwaj and Himanshu Kaushik. Okay, that's me. So in this series of videos, we are going to guide you about what are the different options you have after doing after giving the GATE examinations, and what if you don't clear the GATE examination. So these videos are intended for the students who have given GATE 2017 and they are expecting a good rank, or they are not expecting a good rank, or they are expecting that they will not be able to qualify the GATE examination. Okay, and this is also for the students who have who haven't appeared for GATE and want to do post graduation even without the GATE score. And even this is for the students who want to join the government sector jobs, PSU jobs. Like, we have different PSU jobs of ONGC, IOCL, EIL. So if you want to join these kind of PSUs, then still we are going to explain in what rank you can get what kind of PSUs. So here we have Shubham Saxena. Shubham Saxena has done his m.tech from IIT Bombay, and he'll be guiding you about the various admission procedures in these IITs and what rank you can expect what kind of college. Okay, so the first is we are going to target the students who got a rank between 1 to 35.
Yeah.
So Shubham sir.
Yeah, so if you get under 60 rank, so EIR below 60, so you can say 1 to 60, then you will be definitely getting IIT Bombay direct admission. And IIT Bombay always takes direct admission for TA ship. So
what is TA ship, sir?
Teaching assistant. So
teaching assistant, okay.
Yeah. So there are two type of courses in IIT Bombay for M.Tech Masters, one is RA research and one for TA, teaching assistant. So TA is basically 2 year course and one is RA, which is 3 years course, 3 year M.Tech degree. So for RA category, the rank can be much more than 350 also, but for TA you need at least, means if you go on direct admission without any hassle, you will be needing at least 60 marks.
Okay.
60 rank, AIR 60, yeah.
Okay.
At most 60, yeah. So for 60, you can also get IIT Kanpur direct admission. You can get into ISC as well, ISC Bangalore.
Okay.
For MS program.
IIC Bangalore?
Yeah, for MS. So okay. IIT Bombay, IIT Kanpur, these are for M.Tech, and IIC Bangalore for MS.
Okay.
And IIT Delhi, also you can get if and only if you have 75% marks in B.Tech also.
In B.Tech and a rank which should
rank
be less
should
than?
Be less than 60, yeah.
Okay, rank should be less than 60.
Yeah.
Okay.
So even less than 60 or maybe less than 80 also. So this is a category where we are talking about less than 60. So IIC Bangalore is the only college which you can assure in less than 60. So above 60, you may or may not get IIC Bangalore.
Okay.
So let's target the next range, which is 60 to 100.
60 to 100. Okay.
Yeah. So in this range, we can get IIT Bombay easily. For TA category.
Okay.
So IIT Bombay you can get up to 100 rank.
Up to 100 rank.
Yeah. So 0 to
0 to
100.
Okay.
1 to 100. Yeah. So IIT Kanpur you may get IIT Kanpur, but you will have to give an interview and written test also.
Interview and written.
Yeah.
So we don't have interview and written in IIT Bombay?
We don't have written and interview for IIT Bombay. Yeah.
Okay, so we have direct admissions in IIT Bombay.
Yes.
Okay.
In IIT Delhi also, you can get direct admission if your marks are in your B.Tech, your marks are
which is greater than 70%.
Yeah, greater than 75%.
75%.
Yeah, it is 75%, not 70%.
Okay, 75%.
So there also it is 75. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So now, if your marks are not 75% in B.Tech, then also you can go into IIT Delhi. They will take one written test or interview also.
Okay.
Then, yeah. So the mostly they will take from your GATE rank, even though they will take a written interview.
So I think you, when you got admission in IIT Bombay, you first of all you got IIT Delhi, then you got
yes,
IIT
yes,
Bombay.
Yes, I got IIT Delhi and then I got IIT
Okay,
Bombay.
What was the difference between IIT Delhi and IIT Bombay? I think you took some classes in IIT Delhi also before you started in IIT Bombay.
No, I didn't take any class.
Okay.
So on the third list itself, IIT Bombay, third list, I got selected. So I went to IIT Bombay without joining IIT Delhi.
Okay.
So I just paid fees for IIT Delhi, that's it.
Okay.
And then I went to IIT Bombay.
IIT Bombay, great.
Yes.
Okay, and then?
So now, shall we target next? So you can also get into, you can assume other IITs. So like IIT Kharagpur, all these IIT Roorkee, you can get in these ranks also.
Okay.
But the thing is, we are talking about range wise. So IIT Bombay, let's say, it is the best IIT in terms of placement and the study also. So if you want to go for research, the IIT Kanpur is the best for research.
Okay.
So all these things. So let's say first is ISC Bangalore, then IIT Bombay, then IIT Kanpur, then IIT Delhi. So this is the this is how we think that okay, these are the top IIT, these are the top good colleges.
So that means if I can categorize them according to the top ranking, so you can say IIT Bangalore is the first one.
Yes.
Right. So then we have IIT Bombay.
IIT Bombay.
Then we have IIT Delhi.
IIT Kanpur, Delhi.
IIT Delhi and Kanpur both are same, because I think IIT Kanpur is the oldest IIT. So it started in 1950s and 1954, and I think sometimes in B.Tech only rank one chosen IIT Kanpur as preferred IIT Kanpur as compared to IIT Delhi and IIT Bombay.
Yes.
So IIT Kanpur is more famous for research as compared to any other IIT, and IIC Bangalore is purely for research.
Yes.
Okay, great.
And there is also one IIT Madras.
Okay.
Which also has same type of placement as IIT Delhi, Kanpur or Bombay.
Okay.
And which is also mainly focused on the placement. So
placements.
IIT Madras, we can get easily, we can get the same placement, same package, which we will be getting from IIT Bombay or
okay,
IIT.
Okay, so after IIT Madras, we have IIT Kharagpur.
IIT Kharagpur, yes.
Okay, then?
Then IIT Roorkee, Guwahati, all these.
IIT Roorkee, okay. And IIT Guwahati.
Yes.
So these are the old IITs. These are these are old
IITs.
Six IITs and one IIC Bangalore. So there's seven colleges.
Mm-hmm.
Great. Okay, sir. Then if we are getting a rank which is 1 to 350, so do we have choices for PSUs also?
Yes, we have choices for PSUs. So there are many PSUs which take from gate directly. So lists is like IUCL takes.
Okay.
And BBNL.
BBNL.
GAIL. ONGC. And this time BSNL is also taking for CSE branch.
Okay.
There is BHEL, BHEL.
Okay.
And so there are other PSUs also which take from GATE. But for computer science, this is the list.
These are the PSUs. Okay. Yes. So Power Grid is not recruiting from GATE 2017.
Yes, Power Grid also take from.
Okay, Power Grid is all this.
Yes.
Okay. So out of all these PSUs, what are the PSUs which are having the highest salary? If a student want to go check the PSU according to salary, so what are the PSUs which are having the highest salary?
So Power Grid is giving the highest salary, but the seats are very low. So you will be expecting either one or two seat. So you have to be in top 20.
Top 20.
Yes.
Okay.
You have to be in top 20 to get into Power Grid.
Okay. And then we have ONGC and IOCL. These are second highest salary pairs.
Yes,
right.
Second highest. And to be in IOCL, so this time seats are very high. So the recruitment will be in, let's say, many people will be recruited. So you can assume under 200 rank, you can get into IOCL this year.
What about ONGC?
ONGC, you can get into 150 or 200.
Under 150 or 200.
Yeah.
Great. And then we have BBNL.
BBNL, GAIL, these are all already taking. So seats are very low, but you can get in top 100 or top 150. 150,
okay.
You can say.
Top 150. So they are not having packages as compared to IOCL and ONGC. But still, they are also very good choices.
Yes.
Right. So BBNL is a purely government organization, right? So Bharat Broadband.
I don't know about that.
Okay.
So BSNL this time recruiting, I think 2700 seats are there.
2700,
so
I think 2700 something seats are there.
So you can assume below 350 or maybe 500 you can get
so
into
because
BSNL.
I think they're recruiting from 6 or 7 branches. Like we have instrumentation, radiology, electronics and communication, electrical and electronics. So my prediction is they are going to take somewhere around 500 seats, 500 vacancies. So maybe if a student is under 1000, this time they are having very high chances or probability of getting into one of the PSUs.
Yes.
Okay, so see, previously I used to think that BSNL is a government organization, but now I realize that BSNL is not a government organization, it is
a PSU.
Right, okay.
VAIL also same 150, 200.
150 to 200.
Even VAIL you can assume for 600 also.
600.
Yeah, up to 600 you can get.
Up to this time.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
And then let's come to some. Okay, so these are I think the pretty much companies which you can
and
get.
And see, what about BARC and ISRO? So you can can you choose BARC and ISRO?
Yes, you can choose BARC and ISRO. These are very, so BARC you can get up to, let's say, 1000, maybe 1500.
Okay.
So that's why
so
I am
1000.
Not discussed here. So
okay, great. So we are going to discuss BARC and ISRO after
this.
Yes.
So all these all the colleges which you can get in 1 to 350, you can easily get into 350, more than 350 also.
Okay.
So we will be covering from the best part.
Okay.
Not the overall range.
Overall range.
Okay. So now let's come to that's 350 to 700.
700.
So there are colleges like there are colleges like
IIT Mandi.
Yeah. So all these new IITs.
Mm-hmm.
New
IITs.
IITs.
Okay.
And even we can also assume we can also get into IIT Bombay.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to do M.Tech from IIT Bombay, this
IIT
is a 3 years course.
3 years course.
Yeah, RA-ship.
RA-ship.
Yeah.
Okay.
So this I think this is better than TA, but
mm-hmm.
for TA you need good rank. For RA you don't need good rank, but you'll have to clear the interview.
So but the placement is same for RA,
yes,
and TA?
Placement is same, and even RA-ship is better because you get to learn for placement. You get to learn for placement and you get to learn for the research purposes.
Research purposes.
So you can also go for PhD after that, or you can go join the same company which a TA will join. So this you need to crack the interview also.
Okay, so for this you need interview plus written. Is there any written test?
Written test is also there, interview will be there.
Okay, written plus interview.
Yes.
Great.
And all these so top NITs you can get in up to 700. So NIT,
so you can see old NITs which are the top ones, like NIT
Trichy, Warangal.
Okay.
Or
Trichy, Warangal,
some top NIT, so you can
okay.
get from CCMT. So there is an
CCMT counseling will be there.
Yes. So CCMT counseling, so best IITs are chosen for best rankers.
Okay.
So
even you can get new IITs like IIT Patna and etc.
Yeah, new IITs you can easily get. ISM Dhanbad is now
mm-hmm.
a new IIT. ISI also.
And
IIT BHU.
IIT BHU, Banaras Hindu University.
Yes.
So you will be targeting within this rank only.
Yes.
Okay.
And so this is pretty much, so now let's come to the PSU part.
Mm-hmm.
For this range you can get into BARC now.
BARC?
Yeah, BARC you can get into 1 to 350 also, but now you can get into BARC as well. And you
ISRO.
Can ISRO, you can ISRO takes different exams, so
okay.
it will not take from GATE, or maybe it takes from GATE, I don't
different exam. Okay, yeah. Sometimes ISRO recruit from GATE, I think.
Yes, okay.
They also take the different exams. Mostly they take the different exams.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then you in 350 to 700, this time you will get BSNL.
BSNL.
And you have high chances of getting into IUCL also.
IUCL, okay.
Yes. Because this time...
this time they are having very good number of vacancies.
Yes. So maybe 45 to 50 they are taking, so you
okay.
can get into IUCL also.
Mm-hmm.
And other PSUs, I don't see any PSU which you can get for 700 rank.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. ONGC maybe very
ONGC
rare.
I think
seats are very
ONGC
less.
Seats are very less.
Yes.
In ONGC you require at least less rank, which is less than
yes.
200.
Yes.
Yes.
So if there is a priority, like someone want to go to IOCL and they want to leave ONGC, then only you will get a chance to get. So, assuming the case that ONGC recruits at the end,
mm-hmm.
or maybe after IUCL,
then you can get a chance to go
into ONGC. Yeah.
Okay, so then we are here with rank 700 to 100.
700 to 1500.
1500.
So
yes.
you can get into IIT Madras.
Madras.
Yes.
Okay.
So there is one MS program there for
mm-hmm.
3 year course. So
right.
you can get into it, and
we have even we have a choice of IIT Delhi MS program.
Yes, IIT Delhi MS program you can get in up to 1000.
Up to 1000.
Yes.
Okay.
And then you have top NITs also you can get, like NIT Trichy maybe you can get this time, NIT
mm-hmm.
Suratkal, NIT Calicut, and MNIT Allahabad, MNITs you can get.
Okay.
Good MNIT. So Allahabad is the good MNIT. Manit.
Okay.
Sorry, it's MNIT. Yeah.
So Malviya National Institute of Technology.
Mm.
So it is also NIT.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
And so these are the top NITs which you can get for this range. And for
so
like
maybe again you have a chance for BSNL also.
Yes, we have chance for BSNL here, as far as PSU is concerned.
Okay.
And then we have we can get. Okay, so this is the, so here we are covering for GATE perspective, so
yes,
not GATE, non-GATE, so there are some colleges which take also from GATE and also from non-GATE, so like VIT is a college which takes their own exam as well as they take from GATE also. So there are other colleges also which take without GATE.
Okay, so now here we are at rank 1500 to 3000. So what are the colleges students can focus in this way? Because there are a lot of colleges which are available. There's a huge list in this case.
Yes. So yes. NIT mostly, the remaining NIT you can get easily from 1500 to 3000.
Okay.
So and VARC also you can get a chance to give an interview.
Okay.
So for VARC also, and
you have triple IITs.
We have triple IITs.
Right. Yeah. Even a triple IIT Bangalore. See, these are different things. Even triple IIT Hyderabad is a different entity. Triple IIT Allahabad is a different entity. Even triple IIT Delhi is a different
entity. Yes. These triple IITs, all triple IITs. This name is same. Otherwise, that would
because
they are not anyway joined.
Right. Because triple IIT Delhi is having the full form as Indraprastha Institute of Information Technology, and triple IIT Allahabad is Indian Institute of Information Technology.
Yes.
So these are different triple IITs.
Yes.
Okay.
So triple IITs you can get for up to 3000 rank. You can also get some, so merit and MNITs you will get.
Mm-hmm.
So all these colleges you can get.
Okay. Even we have the tier two colleges, tier two, tier three colleges like Delhi Technical University.
Yes.
DTU, Jadavpur University.
If they take from GATE, you can usually get into those
right.
colleges.
So what are the list of those colleges at least? We have a complete list.
Yes. We have a complete list. We don't have complete list, obviously. We will tell only the colleges which you should do M.Tech and means you should get good placement. Otherwise, if we start telling all the colleges, then means you will end up getting 2.5 lakh package and you will say, okay, Shubham sir told me that this is a good college. So we will not be sharing any college which is not good or from the perspective of your placement. So we will be only telling where you can get at least placement of 8 lakh. So we are covering like that. So if we talk about PSUs from 1500 to 3000, you can get maybe BSNL you can get.
BSNL?
Yeah, BSNL you have chances to get in.
Okay.
And so this Bell वगैरह ये सब का तो exam आप अलग से ही देते हैं, ठीक है?
ठीक है.
So this is about up to 3000. From 3000 to 7000, you have colleges which are like state colleges and other colleges which you can get. So
mm-hmm.
there are good colleges and they will have similar placement, not same placement, but means
standard placements.
Yeah, standard placement. So you can assume at least 6 lakh, 7 lakh placement from this time.
Mm-hmm.
So after 2 years, nobody knows how computer science will grow or how any other branch will grow.
Correct.
So like Delhi Technical University, Jabalpur, Jadavpur University, and some triple IIT Jabalpur, triple IIT Gwalior, Punjab Engineering College,
PEC.
Yeah.
We have JNTU.
And Pondicherry JNTU. So all.
So these are central universities.
Okay.
So see, guys, just to tell you that there are two types of universities we have. Number one, we have central universities, and second, we have state universities. State universities are generally, if it is a government university, then it is governed by the state government. Like for example, in Haryana, we have MDU, that is Maharishi Dayanand University, that is a state university. We have DCRUST. We have different universities are only state universities, and they are governed by the state government. And the central universities are governed by the center.
Mm.
Right, so there is a central government, and the central universities are very good as compared to the state universities, and they're having very good placement packages. For example, even if you take the universities like we have Banaras Hindu University, which is now an IIT, Banaras Hindu University was a central university, it was managed by the central government. Okay.
Yeah, so this range, I think PSU, I rarely think some PSU will take from this range.
Right, so it hardly you can expect some kind of PSUs in this range.
Yeah, for this rank.
But you can get some central universities.
Yeah, so from the GATE score, you cannot get into PSU, but you can easily get into some government organization through giving their own exam. Like ISRO takes their own exam, BARC takes their own exam. So we will cover that in a non-GATE part. So as far as the GATE rank is concerned, you will not get anything other
than this.
Yes.
Okay.
So let's come to the next, which is student who don't have good rank. So if your rank is more than 7000, then maybe you will not get any good college, good NIT college, or maybe any good college which takes from GATE, and then you will get a good placement. For this range, I think this range is same as those who have just qualified the gate, and they so
correct.
You have just qualified the gate, that's it, you have not actually gained anything.
See, in this case range, what I'll suggest is you can take admissions in these good colleges because you will not be wasting your year.
Yes.
And generally if you qualify the gate examination, then government give you a stipend of around 12,400 rupees per month.
Yes.
So what you can do is you can take admissions in these good colleges. These are standard okay colleges, and you can standard colleges, you can say.
Yeah, so the thing about this range is more than 7,000. So suppose your range is in between 7,000 to 10,000. So what happens, these students are intelligent. So they do some silly mistakes or maybe calculation mistake. That's why their score come down, and so this range becomes. So if you see, there is only difference of 1 or 2 marks for this 1,000 or 2,000 range. So 7,000 to 10,000. These many ranks, but the difference will be of mostly minimum 5 marks or 6 marks. So these students are intelligent. If they have just got 7,000 in gate, they can easily qualify the other colleges exam, like
right.
BIT and IIIT. They can easily clear that.
Like some private universities are also taking their own exam. Like
yeah.
We have JP University. It is also a very good
yes.
university. So nearby university, they are also taking their own
mm-hmm.
examination.
So these students are intelligent and they can clear that exam
okay.
and get into the same those colleges, and those after doing M.Tech or post-graduation from those colleges, they will get the same placement which an IIT will get.
So can you take name also? Can you give name of some of the colleges which they can refer in this category?
Yes. So for this category, you can like VIT is a college, Manipal, Thapar. Nirma University is also there. MIT, if they take from GATE, I don't know if they take from GATE.
I think MIT is, I don't consider it as a
okay.
very good university personally.
Yeah, okay. the JNTU is a good college. And Andhra University, Maharashtra Institute of Technology, Pune, Bengal Engineering and Science University.
But even there's in Pune, there's a government college also, the Army College, which takes admission in this rank category. I think that if your rank is between 3,000 to 7,000, then there's a Army College in Pune, Defense College of Engineering, I think. So they take admission between this range.
Okay.
Yeah.
And there is Coimbatore Institute of Technology. So all these colleges, they are good colleges, CBIT Hyderabad.
Mm-hmm.
And you can all easily clear the exams of these colleges and get in. You will get the similar placement. So mainly, if we talk about JNTU, VIT Vellore, and Thapar University, these colleges, these are the colleges which will get you, which from where you can get a very good placement, or maybe you will not need a placement. They will simply give job of teaching in their colleges. So these are some good, very good colleges. Thapar, VIT and JNTU, you should consider these colleges also. So now we will talk about the students which have not qualified GATE or haven't appeared for GATE but want to do a post graduation. So the list of colleges which I'm going to tell is the list which gives you the same placement which an IIT will get, but doing M.Tech from these private colleges. So list may be, so there is one college, IIIT Hyderabad. This is a very good college. You will get the similar placement. VIT Vellore, and now VIT will having two more colleges this year. So VIT Hyderabad, I think, and then there is one more VIT. So please fill the VIT form if you are expecting more than 7,000 rank. If you are getting good rank, then no need to fill, otherwise please fill VIT form. If you have not appeared for the GATE, then you must fill VIT. VIT is same as IIT, so faculty is very good there.
Then we have Jamia University,
Jamia
yeah. Hamdard.
Yes.
Okay.
And then we have BITS Plani, which is a very good, very good college. And one ISI.
See, we have BITS Mesra and BITS Plani. So these are two different colleges, right?
Yeah, I haven't heard about Miss BITS Mesra.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Plani,
so
I know
these are two different colleges.
Okay.
BITS Mesra and BITS Plani, they are not the branch of each other. I think so. I heard from someone. I'm not sure. We have to check that on internet. But
okay.
I think they are different colleges.
Hmm. Okay. Is it a good college, BITS?
Generally, if a student get a rank around 7,000, then he can get selected into BITS Mesra.
Okay.
And for BITS Plani, you need a better rank.
Yes.
Yeah, you need to have a rank which is less than 3,000.
Yeah. For BITS, I think you can also give private.
Their own examination.
Their own examination. Yeah.
Yeah.
And now we have
different state in examinations also.
Mm. So there is PU, Punjab University,
Manipal there.
University. So these are good universities. So basically in these this list, I think IIIT Hyderabad and VIT Vellore, these are the two colleges from where you will get the same placement and same feel like you will get in get from IIT. So take any IIT, IIT Bombay, IIT Delhi, IIT Kanpur, the teachers, faculties and the placement will be same as in IIIT Hyderabad and VIT Vellore.
Okay, so we have one more choice of IPU CET.
Yes, so this is also a good college.
That is for in Delhi, IPU University in Delhi, you can take admission to IPU University. And there are some good colleges which take admission from CET examination.
Yes.
Like this Center of Research, CDAC Noida.
Yes, so CDAC, you will need a CET rank.
Right.
For CDAC. So
CDAC actually just to tell you guys, CDAC recruit from gate examination. So they take admission through gate examination. If you have a rank which is less than 3000, then you can take admission in CDAC. But if you have not got a good rank in gate, or if you miss the gate examination, then you can easily give the IPU CET examination. Using this examination, you can also get CDAC if they have some seats which are left or vacant.
Yes.
Yeah.
And
then we have some state university examinations, like we have TenSet.
TenSet,
which is the Tamil Nadu state, right? Then we have PGCET, and then we have other examination like UPES, right? And we have PGECET. There are two different examinations. This is PGCET, and second one is PGECET. So these are two different examinations.
Yes.
Okay, one is for Karnataka, one is
for
Tamil Nadu.
So mainly for post-graduation, these are the state universities. Examination.
And even if you haven't got a good rank in GATE, or if you miss the GATE examination, the second choice is you can still continue your preparation right now, and you can give the examinations of BARC. BARC takes its own examination, which is OCES and DCES.
Yes.
And we have DRDO take its own examination for a junior category, that is CEPTEM, CEPTM. And we have ISRO also take its own examination. So you can continue your preparation for BARC, ISRO, DRDO, SAIL, BIS and RBI. They take their own examination. And even you can also prepare for bank SO, specialist officer.
Yes.
Because in specialist officer, you have aptitude part which is there, but the technical part is also there. So the things which you studied in GATE for the technical part, that is also going to help you in bank specialist officer.
Yes.
Okay.
So now this is about post-graduation. Let's look at the job part if we want to do job in...
Okay.
If we have not given GATE exam and if we want to do job, then what are our options?
Okay.
So non-GATE part. So without GATE, there are some good organization like BARC is there, and one is ISRO, and one is BEL, BEL, and then we have SAIL, and RVI or other. So these are all government organization. There is a list you can get easily from internet which are recruiting non-GATE students also. So BARC is basically takes from GATE also. So there is two type of people which go to BARC. So one is from GATE, so up to 3500, maybe 4000 also, you will get a chance to give a BARC interview. And if you don't have GATE score which is rank below 3500, then you will have to give their own separate exam, and if you qualify that exam, then you will be also called for that interview. And there is ISRO, then it is ISRO, which is a central government. So BARC is also central government, ISRO is also central government. These are not PSUs. So for ISRO also, you will have to give their written test, and then they will take interviews. An interview will be simple, but written test mainly if you qualify that. And the syllabus is same for ISRO and BARC, for computer science at least, it is same. But for interview, BARC, I think you have already heard that BARC interview is very tough. So you'll have to choose any five subjects, and then they will ask from those subjects. So you'll have to have a deep understanding in those subjects. So then BEL, which is placement is not that good as BARC and ISRO. But it is worth considering, because it is giving at least 6 lakh or 7 lakh of package. So BEL, you can simply, they will take their own exam. Sometimes they take from GATE also. And SAIL also same, they will take their own exam, and then they also maybe consider GATE rank, but they will give the same package, 6 to 7 lakh. So if you want good package, then VARC is giving good package and ISRO will be giving good packages because they are central government organization and they the pay scale of central government is high. And then BEL, SAIL and RBI, these are all PSUs.
Okay, a part of this, there's one more point I wanted to discuss.
Mm-hmm.
Is that is, what is the difference between CTC and the salaries package which you are going to get in this government organization? Because I think in ISRO, IOCL and ONGC, they give you a CTC of around 14.95 lakhs per
yes.
annum. And the in-hand salary is very less as compared to 14.95
yes.
lakhs. So what is the in-hand salary you are getting in IOCL?
So in-hand salary, maybe 10 lakh or 11 lakh.
Okay, around in-hand is around 10 lakhs.
So that too after 2 years of working. So initially I would be getting around 8 lakh.
8 lakhs, that is somewhere around 50 to 60,000.
Yes.
But if you check in these PSUs, these are government organizations.
So, no, the CTC for, so my in-hand, matlab, gross salary was 8 lakh, but
mm-hmm.
CTC for that time was 12 lakh only.
Okay.
For IOCL. And for Power Grid, the CTC is 14.95.
Okay.
And in-hand is around 12 lakh.
In-hand is 12 lakh.
Yeah, which I have heard. I don't know exactly what the salary.
Okay.
So I just heard it. So the thing about CTC and gross salary is so many people interpret in many ways, but for simplicity, I'm just telling. So let's say CTC is the full form of CTC is cost to company. So whatever company is giving to you is cost to company. They will, if they are even giving you money to buy, let's say glasses, spectacles, or maybe they are giving you HRA, whatever things they are giving, they will consider into cost to company. And gross is the in-hand salary which you get after cutting the taxes. So, or maybe without cutting the taxes. So taxes we can exclude or include depending on the company. So cost to company will be always higher because when you go in any government organization or PSUs, so you will get many other things, perks, allowances, which are not counted as a gross salary. So that's, so it for PSU, it is very, very nominal, you can say very less difference in CTC and gross, so around 2 lakh or 3 lakh maybe.
But I think in ISRO and BARC, you get
yeah.
a in-hand salary of 40 to 50 thousand.
Yes, yes.
Plus you get other perks like you get a flat or something, right?
Yes, yes. So right. BARC and ISRO, these are very good in comparison to work as well as the money. So Power Grid is only giving more salary than BARC and ISRO. So BARC and ISRO, you should consider. And these two they do not take from gate, so you'll have to give
a different examination for them.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you want to discuss anything in this video?
So I think this is pretty much all we have. We have all other options, or mainly for computer science, but this is for all branches. So mainly for computer science, but it will work for all branches also.
Okay, so guys, just for an update, as soon as the result of the GATE 2017 will come out, we will do an online live session
yes.
for interview guidance, and Shivam Saxena sir will be there. I think the date for the result is on 27th of March,
mm.
right? So on the same day, on the result day, we'll be online and we'll be guiding you for all the colleges you can prefer according to the rank you can get, you are getting, and what are the things will get updated till that time.
Yes. So one more thing I would like to add on is that so you suppose you get a very good rank and you have choice of so n number of colleges, so all the IITs you can get all the, so from those IITs, how to choose my preferable means your preferred IIT. So one is the point you consider is your placement, how you will get a placement in IIT Delhi or IIT Bombay if you want to choose from these two. Second is how which where you can get a good teacher or a good professor under which you will have to do all the research things and all. So we will discuss it after whenever your result will come, then I think that will be more suitable if we discuss it there rather than here in these slides. Okay.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you.